witness the witnesses of those who are going to tell about their lives, how Christ has encountered them. And we are going to live the passion today. We have our parishioners who are almost ready, and we will be witnessing different people of the walks of life who will be coming and explaining their passion. So let us encourage each other as they are one who really experienced Christ. We all experience Christ. Each one experienced Christ in a different way. Let us pray.
Last seven words of Jesus. Welcome to the reflection of the last seven words of Jesus. As we reflect on Christ's sacrifice this Good Friday,
despised and rejected by all. A man of sorrow, a man of grief.
The last seven statements. The last seven words of Jesus reveal his humanity, love, and trust in God. Let us together now reflect on these seven words Jesus spoke and understand of how it holds a profound meaning and relevance even in today's world, and how we can apply these seven words and live like Jesus has called us to live. Let it offer us guidance, comfort, and inspiration to help us navigate the challenges of life and grow in our relationship with God and all around us.
The first word, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Luke chapter 23, verse 34. This first word shows Jesus' compassion and forgiveness towards his executioners, even as they were inflicting great pain upon them. By interceding for his transgressors through this prayer, Jesus fulfilled the Old Testament prophecy foretold by Isaiah. This prayer from upon the cross particularly would have been a confirmation of his identity to those awaiting their beloved Messiah. It reminds us to practice forgiveness in our own lives, even towards those who hurt us. The statement, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do, is a powerful reminder of Christ's love and forgiveness for all of us, even when we have wronged him. Let us today forgive and seek forgiveness from our parents. Sorry for disobeying you, never understanding you, and all your sacrifices. Let us take a moment to accept our negative behavior towards our parents and also forgive our parents for their shortcomings. Let us approach them with love and understanding. Husbands and wives taking each other for granted, it is important to remember that love is not just a feeling but a choice. It is easy to become complacent in a relationship and forget to appreciate the small things. But by choosing to forgive and love our spouse, even in the midst of hurt, we can strengthen our bond and grow closer to one another.
The second word, truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. Luke chapter 23, verse 43. In this word, Jesus speaks to one of the thieves who was crucified alongside him. offering him hope and comfort.
The third word, woman, behold your son. Son, behold your mother. John chapter 19, verses 26 to 27. The third word shows Jesus' concern for his mother Mary, entrusting a care to his disciple John. It also emphasizes the importance of community and caring for one another as family. Even in difficult times, do we show care and compassion to others?
Will take care of them.
Without family, nothing else matters. Everything from the bottom to top falls apart or descends into chaos. The loss of home leaves a gap that can never be filled. It is here that people like Robert Arana and his wife become parents and family to the boys at Sneha Sadan and take care of them as their own children. The boy found next to a dead body at VT station, supposedly left behind by his uncle, or the person who met with a train accident and was disabled with no trace of his family. Both have grown up at Sneha Sadan and now settled in their lives. Let us hear from Mr. Robert Arana speak about his experience of taking care of others as Jesus asked us to take.
The fourth word. My God, why have you forsaken me? Matthew chapter 26, verse 46. In this word, Jesus quotes from Psalm 22, expressing his sense of abandonment and suffering. He felt helpless and lost. It is a reminder that even the Son of God experienced feelings of despair and questioning, and that it is okay to cry out to God in our own times of despair and helplessness.
Someone in there inside the house, please open the door. Is someone inside the house, please open the door. I need help. Please open the door. I need help. Please. Oh God.
Sunlight, Moja Deva.
The fifth word, I thirst. John chapter 19, verse 18. I thirst highlights Jesus' physical suffering on the cross, but it also speaks to a deeper spiritual thirst for connection with God. It reminds us that we are all searching for something to satisfy our souls, and that only God can truly quench our thirst.
The sixth word, it is finished. John chapter 19, verse 30. Jesus knew that his mission was now finished. And to fulfill the scripture, he said, I am thirsty. It is finished is not about the end or giving up, but its theological meaning is around accomplishment or completion. Jesus was sent by his Father on a mission. He completes his mission to save humanity through his sacrifice. The word victory signifies that the mission is achieved. It reminds us that we all on this earth are there on a mission. Do we discern to God's calling and figure out our mission? Sometimes we may get an early call of God's mission in our lives. However, we may ignore and not be able to discern the call. We become focused on worldly missions rather than discerning to our true mission. We are called to live lives of purpose. Unless we have a purpose, we have very little meaning in what we do. The sign of maturity is to discern our spiritual gifts and abilities and then order ourselves so as to maximize what God has given to us. We are called to live lives of focus. Sometimes we may take time to figure out our priorities. When we are focused and disciplined and surrender ourselves to God, we can identify our mission.
The seventh word, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. Luke chapter 23, verse 46. This last word on the cross shows Jesus' complete trust in God, even as he breathes his last. It is a reminder that we too can trust in God to carry us through the challenges and transitions of life, and that death is not the end of our journey, but a beginning of new life. That is resurrection.
Amen.
in Romans chapter 8, verse 38 to 39 wrote, I am convinced that nothing can separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today, nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. It is easy to let busyness distract us and problems discourage us. But today, let us all set everything aside to sit at the foot of the cross. Let us stop to reflect on Jesus' last words of love and rest in the hope of his miraculous life-giving promises. Amen.
He was despised and rejected by all, a man of sorrow, a man of grief, as one from whom people hide their faces. He was despised without esteem, and he was wounded for our transgressions. Was tortured for our iniquities, and his chastisement has brought us healing.